Hello, my name is Dr. Shelley Sommerfeldt. I'm a psychologist and relationship coach with the Loving Roots Project. And today I'd like to speak about the importance of date nights in your relationship. It is so important to remember that courting, dating, and keeping intimacy and connection alive in your relationship is essential. It's essential to the well-being and the overall relationship happiness that you may experience. Being consistent with having a date night or setting aside time to just spend alone with your partner can sometimes be challenging. We all know that life is hectic, chaotic, and just plain stressful. So finding the time, energy, and effort to get some alone time with your significant other can sometimes be difficult. It's very important that this is not overlooked, though. Once we get too wrapped up into our day-to-day activities and forget about putting importance and effort into our relationships, we can let the passion drift away. When people have been in a relationship for many years, it's easy to get comfortable, complacent, and not put forth that effort and work that relationships require in order to stay connected. We've all heard people say that relationships take a lot of work, and honestly, they're right. But the hard work doesn't have to be viewed as a negative thing. Working hard on your relationship can also be fun. Date nights are one of those aspects of having fun. By having connection and intimacy, relationships are important in terms of being part of our human experience and social experience. So staying connected is really important. It keeps us motivated, supported, feeling good about ourselves, and loving of others. So now, let's review some things that you can do to establish a routine of date nights in your relationship. Number one, set a goal. It's important that you and your partner agree on a goal for establishing a date night. People have different thoughts on what's realistic and helpful for them. One couple may prefer weekly date nights, while another may find that to be too much or too challenging to accomplish, so they aim for once a month. Find what's right for you and your partner. Be sure to discuss this as a goal so that you're on the same page and have the same expectations. Having a shared goal such as this may seem simple, but it really allows both parties to know what's expected and puts the expectation on both people to carry it out. And number two, get creative. This is an opportunity to try something new and different. One thing to remember is that date nights don't always have to be going out. This can be challenging for couples with young children. So you may have to get creative. There are ways to set up a special meal at home or even enjoy an intimate dessert after the kids are asleep. You can bring romance into your home by setting up a nice table or light candles. You don't always have to leave your home for date night. You can try new things at home or get out of your regular routine and go somewhere new. Try new restaurants that you haven't been to. Try a picnic at the park or local concert. You can even find a local Facebook event. Or take a class together, a nearby day trip. It's important that both parties contribute and put down some things on a list that maybe interest them. This way, you're both contributing ideas. So take some time and brainstorm some creative things to do together. And number three, take turns planning. This can be a fun step. Have each party plan a surprise date night for the other. So if you choose weekly date nights, then it's your partner's responsibility 1 week to plan something and yours on another week. This is where you can really pull in that creativity and find something to do as a surprise for your partner, a thoughtful activity. Each person may have a difference on what's important to them and why. So each partner gets a chance to plan something that they would enjoy or that their partner would enjoy. This also changes up who initiates things in the relationship, which can be a nice change of pace, especially if you've been stuck with a familiar routine. It also allows that each partner brings in an element of spontaneity and can surprise the other. It also shifts responsibility to both parties. And number four, enjoy. When you set the goal, get creative, and take turns planning a date, be sure to enjoy the moment. This can be easier said than done, especially in our stressful and busy lives. It can be easy for some people to get distracted while they're on a date, or think about or talk about their work or their kids, or just constantly check their phones and not really be focused on connecting with their partner. The goal here is to increase connection. So do your best to disconnect from other activities and really be present in the moment. Have meaningful conversations that's important to you and your relationship. Date night should be positive, pleasurable, and fun. So set up a date night routine with your partner, get creative, and most importantly, enjoy.